Greetings, unsettled souls, and welcome to The Correct Views. It is Dunce Cap of the Month show. Normally, I'm in the studio, but as you can hear from the ding-dinging behind me, my printer will not work, and I am trapped in the room that is not my studio, which is fine, because the dumbies that I'm giving you have been selected specifically for this show. I just did a whole show of idiots that streamlined all the ones that weren't dumb enough to make tonight's show. So, if you like absolute total idiots, such as you have never seen or heard of before, then you are set. I'm going to be doing a lot of screen sharing instead of having you watch me, because let's face it, it's not going to be all that interesting. The horn.news is giving you things that are quite interesting. Let me go to this one first. Kit Daniels, prisonplanet.com. Social justice warriors accuse Snapchat of racism over Bob Marley weed day filter. Now, this ties in a little bit to the what's going to be the inevitable winner of the Dunce Cap of the Month award. In that you've always heard that the white race is not accepting of the black race. Now, I've never really believed any of that myself, to tell you the truth. I think that's just something they use to divide us. But in any event, it's something you hear quite a bit of. When white people do accept black artists, which is not as rare as they say it is, Little Richard opened up the door for people, and then years later they're saying Rihanna opened up the door. Rihanna didn't open up a door. The door was already open. But on a bigger issue, when the people who are not of color embrace the music of those who are of color, then we are told that we have appropriated their culture, that we are stealing their culture. That's ridiculous. One of the most amazing musicians alive today is the one of the bassist, the guitarist person. I say that because he plays both for Animals as Leaders. Quite possibly the best, most talented, most intricate band extant today would probably be Animals as Leaders. And the last time I checked, he was black. However, social justice warriors are accusing Snapchat of racism for creating a filter that turns your face into Bob Marley, despite the fact that the late singer's estate was involved in the filter's creation. Now, I'm going to go out on a limb here and assume that Bob Marley's family was black. The filter, released to honor Marley on Weed Day 2016, morphs people's faces into their reggae icon, complete with dreadlocks, a crochet slouch cap, and facial changes. In response, leftists flooded Snapchat with accusations that the app was a racist blackface filter. Now, that doesn't make any sense, because blackface is something that was done because whites were not allowing black people to perform. Since they are making themselves look like Bob Marley due to the fact that he is, in fact, a performer, doesn't that sort of tell it all to you right there? They are idiots. And you're watching the Dunce Cap of the Month award show. Paul Joseph Watson. English bans its own flag to avoid offending Muslims. Now, this I find particularly interesting because very large numbers of Islam do not care if they offend everybody else. But everybody else is supposed to make sure that they don't offend Islam. I've always been under the belief that you don't have a right not to be offended. But just the same, government officials said that their city was too multicultural to celebrate St. George's Day, which is England's version of the 4th of July. The council said that displaying the English flag may be seen as racist towards immigrants. That's right. They're coming to the country. They're going to blend right in. You know, by making you get rid of your flag. If I could send dunce caps to other countries, that might have been a winner right there. It really might have. If you don't like the flag of the country, then get the hell out of the country and go back to whatever cesspool it is that you supposedly came from because it was so bad you couldn't be there. If you love their flag that much, then go and defend them. If you have any balls, quit annoying the people of England. EAG News, Victor Skinner, Christian school insists dropping Crusaders mascot, not due to political correctness. No, not a chance. A Denver Christian school is changing its Crusaders mascot because some people think it's offensive to Muslims. It's our mission, in light of the command to love our neighbors as ourselves. The Crusader was an inconsistent, inappropriate symbol for that mission, said Denver Christian School CEO Todd Lanting. He told it to KUSA. Now, how many of you are students of history that are listening to me right now? If you are, then what I'm about to say to you is not going to be a surprise. However, if you are not a student of history, you're going to be floored by what I'm about to say to you, and it's all true. That's why the show is called The Correct Views. The Crusades were not an act of Christians butchering Muslims because they were not Christians. It wasn't. It was not about hating the dark-skinned man or hating the Arab or any of that. The Islamic faith is usually spread, I do believe always spread, one way and one way only when it takes over a nation, and that is by the sword. If you don't believe me, I have a real simple, easy to find Google Earth. There is a thing called the Sphinx. Ever hear of it? The Sphinx is not Islamic. The Sphinx is a relic of the ancient Egyptian religion. Why do they not still practice that religion? Because the religion of peace came in and slaughtered the Egyptians and forced them to worship Allah, forced them to accept Muhammad. They did not do it by choice. As a matter of fact, almost every act of conflict in the last 100 years has been with the Muslims not wanting to get along with their neighbors. Not all of them, I get it. There was the Irish-English mess. Of course, there's Russia, the Ukraine, I get it. But especially in that region, it's not other nations not getting along with Muslims. It's Muslims not getting along with other nations. And yet the Crusaders here are going to be demonized as if they are monsters from the pit of hell who hated their fellow man due to the color of their skin. After using the Crusaders mascot for 65 of the school's 100-year history, officials in November began to solicit ideas for a new symbol and have since narrowed it down to two possibilities: thunder and trailblazers. The problem with the old name is that a lot of people were concerned about the association with the Crusades, a series of wars between the Christians and the Muslims. They should be, since the Muslims were slaughtering people and would have destroyed every Christian on the face of the earth if it hadn't been for that. Lanting insists, that's called lying. Lanting lies, and then we change that for you, and says the change is not an effort to align to political correctness. It's got everything to do with love and empathy for our neighbors. No, it has to do with a basic denial of history. That's what it has to do with. And that is why you have made the Dunce Cap of the Month show. And friends, there are four more stories to get to as we do the Dunce Cap. I have streamed it down so that everyone will listen and watch, because the idiots this month all need mention. They are worthy to be called out for the absolute idiots that they are. I want to give a shout out ever so quickly before I go on, though, to Sticker Junkie, because not only do they support the show, but this show has proudly supports them. They make amazing stickers. Our band, my band, Passing Time, gets our stickers made exclusively from Sticker Junkie. Not only are your stickers going to look as good as you're seeing here under the screen share, but you're also going to get a further discount on it. You see, when you check out, let D-Lake know that you heard about it from The Correct Views. And when you do so, you're going to get even more of a discount because you're a listener of the show. So that's a win-win, saving you money. Daily Caller here. Obama administration tells landlords that they can't refuse to house criminals. Brought to you by Change Transportation. Before you call Uber, call Change Transportation. If you usually call Uber, call Change Transportation. They'll price match you. Now, I am a landlord. At least I'm working towards it. I am currently fixing the house up, and I have had people stay there prior to it needing the repairs that it needs now. And I can tell you, there are some people that make no sense at all. For instance, if you live in an area where your next door neighbor has three pubescent girls and an infant boy, for instance, just random, you know, you gotta be politically correct. You have to name all sexes now. Might it be a really good idea for the landlord in the neighboring house to not rent the house to a known sexual predator, for instance? Can you see where that might be a good idea to err on the side of caution? Well, no. Obama says that move the known child molester into that particular house because he knows best, just like he knew best when he destroyed Libya. The Obama administration released a warning Monday telling the nation's landlords that it may be discriminatory for them to refuse to rent to those with criminal records. Now, I am a firm believer that once you have paid your debt to society, you should not be barred from getting jobs. You should not be barred from owning a gun. I get it. I don't have a problem with that. I have a problem, rather, with the idea that there is a time and a place to bring certain people into the home. For instance, if you own a duplex and you suspect that the duplex neighbor is selling crack, you can't prove it. You don't have the grounds to evict them. You just have a really bad feeling about these tenants. Would it be a good idea to move in somebody who just got out of prison for a known drug offense? Probably not. Because now, guess what? Can you figure it out? You did. You're going to have two drug dealers there. There you go. You figured it out. Shazam, Sparky. Might it be a good idea as a landlord to judge the property in question in relation to the person? I know my landlady does it. When she moves in people beside me, since I'm doing this show here at 5:03 in the freaking morning, they tend to be loud. Therefore, a mother with three children, school-aged, might not be the best duplex neighbor for me. That's not racist. That's not unfair. It's common sense and action. The Fair Housing Act doesn't include criminals as a protected class, but the Department of Housing and Urban Development says refusing to rent based on criminal record is a form of racial discrimination due to the racial imbalances in the judicial system. No, maybe if people of certain heritages were not shooting each other. I'm just going to say it. If black people were not killing other black people in numbers that are far higher than anybody else is killing any other person, including whites on blacks, then that might not be the case. I'm dead serious. I don't think we should be locking people up for drugs. I get it. But don't give me that it's racist to send someone to jail because they're black. We're not sending them to jail because they're black. If they are not hurting anybody, they're not being sent to jail at all. In terms of authority lying to get people arrested, that is happening among all colors. That is why I personally don't give much credence to color at all. I don't care what color a person is. I do care if they shot somebody else during a drug deal. I may not want to rent them in my house. If the white person comes in and he's spitting tobacco on my floor, and he's telling me that he got evicted from the last three places he lived in, and that very white person is probably not going to get the house either. And that has nothing to do with me hating white people. Believe it or not, I don't hate white people either. This was good. Council is proud of asking kids to choose their gender. This is from Sky News. It's Brighton Council defends its letter to thousands of parents after it was branded utterly ridiculous by the Tory MP. This is another instance where I wish I could afford to send dunce caps overseas. You can help me do that. Donate at thecorrectviews@hotmail.com. I mention this because this is an awful idea. We have now gone from making sure that Billy, who wants to be called Betty, doesn't get beaten up. I'm all in favor of not beating up Billy Betty. We have gone from that to now what I would consider all-out child abuse. When I was a little kid, I was very addicted to Wonder Woman. How many of you remember the 1970s Wonder Woman? She was hot. She was awesome, and I wanted to be her. So I was drawing with crayons, like damn near carving it into my forehead, any variation of the Wonder Woman logo that I thought I could do. My mom was very quick to point out that I was not a woman and that I would not make a great Wonder Woman. And I went along my merry way doing it and soon moved on to the rest of my life. My mother did not put me in a dress and sign me up for equality classes. This is ridiculous to imply the children of this age have any idea whether they are gay or not, or transgender, whatever BS name you want to give to it. Again, I don't care if a guy wants to cut his schmeckle off, as Michael Savage says, and become a woman. I hate to be the one to tell you, your DNA still calls you a man. It just calls you a man without a schmeckle. Don't blame me. I'm not God. A council leader has said that he is proud of a letter asking children aged 4 to choose their gender that they most identify with. Why don't you just ask them which country to nuke, since clearly they're ready for such decisions? Brighton and Hove City Council wrote to thousands of parents asking them to confirm their primary school places this week. It wrote to parents urging them to support their child's choice of gender identity and ask them to leave the form blank if the child had another gender identity altogether. Now, regular listeners know that I'm hardly a prude when it comes to sex. I have been in situations, and who knows, maybe we'll be again someday, that some people may find less than moral. I don't cheat, and I don't expect other people to accept it, okay? I don't expect beating up down the street because I've had a threesome before, but I don't expect people looming over my shoulder telling me what it is that they expect me to make everybody else accept. That is not the case here. I am also not going out telling children it's a good idea to engage in a threesome, or asking children if they think threesomes are a good idea. This is child abuse, friends. What the hell is this? Brighton and Hove City Council reportedly wrote, "We recognize that not all children and young people identify with the gender that they are assigned at birth or may identify as a gender other than male or female." They don't at all. This is child abuse. Schools should be teaching kids to read and write, not prompting them to consider gender swaps. Andrew Brigden, Tory MP, wisely told the Sun newspaper. He said it's utterly ridiculous. Let me make this real easy for you. If you pee standing up and you have something between your legs that dangles, you are male. If you are not, you are female, regardless of how you feel. Okay, I might feel like a giraffe, but that doesn't mean that I am one. Mind-blowing stupidity. And that brings us up to the runner-up for the dumb D of the day. Only two left. This is from the Providence Journal. I don't think I've ever had the Providence Journal on the show before, so welcome to them. Yeah, mind-blowing stupidity continues here for you. Michael E. Kraft, climate change deniers deserve punishment. In other words, people that tell the truth, people that know that man-made global warming is a lie, people that know that the planet hasn't warmed in 15 to 18 years, people that know that there's more ice in the world than there's ever been before, people that know that climate gate is true, people that know who Lord Monckton is, none of those people who are right, and they are right because there is no global warming, they need punished, according to this genius here. This is the kind of person that would ask a kid if he's gay. Most of us recognize the value of science in dealing with complex problems that pose significant risk to public health and well-being. Thus, we expect reputable science to be reported and used in helping us make difficult policy choices, such as what to do about climate change, which isn't happening. Scientific findings and associated uncertainness should be scrutinized carefully and debated vigorously within the scientific community and among the public. However, it says, denying the best scientific evidence we have is neither smart nor safe, and it could lead to greater societal harm, than we have had taken sensible action when reliable knowledge was first available. Dismissal of well-established climate science has parallels decades of debate over tobacco use and its effect on health. Tobacco companies long denied that there was any causal relation between smoking and disease, even when their own studies proved the opposite to be true. So this dumbass is trying to imply that because the tobacco industry lied, the people that know how to read science are equal to those that kill people by lying about smoking. The difference is smoking does cause cancer, and that man is not warming the planet. Therefore, his entire argument sort of goes down the crapper, doesn't it? So this idiot thinks that there needs to be punishment for people that deny global warming. This is Michael E. Kraft. Make sure you get a hold of him. And when you do, ask him if he has ever heard of the name fascist. If it means anything to him at all. That you can punish someone for what they say. Next, they'll be able to punish you for not believing in God or not believing in Allah. And again, I'm a Christian, but I don't think someone needs punished for denying the fact, and it is a fact, of creation. You know, they're welcome to be wrong, if you to use the analogy. And friends, that brings us to the one and only, the dumdy of the day. Get our dumdy music going. Oh, yes. Are you ready for this, friends? Oh, you're ready. I hope you are. I've got a screen share for this. You can't beat this. All right, enough of the dumdy music. Warning! This is from Fox News Opinion. White people singing Rihanna could cause microaggressions. Now, for those of you that don't know, a microaggression is an act of racism on a small scale, for a lack of better definition. Why does that not make any sense? Because it's illogical, that's why. However, sometimes a whole new level of stupidity can be reached. And look how much Rihanna sort of resembles. What? Look at this. Let me go to this here. I can't even find the Dumdy Award I made now. I think it might already be shut down. That's all right. It didn't print anyway. You can't be singing Rihanna's Umbrella if you happen to be a white fella. That's what kids learned during a lesson on white privilege and microaggressions in human relations theory class at the University of Oklahoma, which would be a wonderful reason to not send your kid to the University of Oklahoma. Yes, there's nothing quite like a bit of white shaming courtesy of the American taxpayers. That's right. You pay tax dollars so that your kid can go to school and be told what to sing based on their color. It's like a reverse Jim Crow law. I was told as a white woman that it is insulting and a microaggression for me to cover or sing Rihanna's song. Because I am not from Barbados, a student who was in the class told me. I was literally told to sing the Star Spangled Banner. All right, two questions then. Doesn't that mean, first of all, that other black people who are not from Barbados, technically speaking, would be committing a microaggression if they sing the Rihanna song, being as that she is from Barbados? Second of all, doesn't that mean that every black artist who has sampled white music in their song is committing a microaggression? Because they are, after all, not white. If all of this sounds stupid, I'm not the one who came up with this. And that's why they're getting the Dunce Cap of the Month Award. I was told as a white... Well, I'm sorry, I read that. As a student who asked to not be identified. I'll be identified. I'll call you out on it. You're welcome to get a hold of me. Sent me copies of both assignments, including a 100-item checklist to determine how much privilege you have. For example, you've got privilege if a stranger has never asked to touch your hair or asked if it's real. Do you want to know why people ask to touch your hair? Normally, because they like your hair. People ask to touch my hair all the time. And this might be surprising to you. Not privileged, and I'm also not black. I know, shocking though it is. Straight white guys who have a job, vacation in Cabo, and go to church on Sunday are very privileged. All right. Being gay isn't a choice. All sex is a choice unless you were raped. Therefore, you can throw the straight thing out the window. White guys who have a job. What about white guys that don't have a job? Maybe they just work for it. Vacation in Cabo. So if you go on a vacation and you actually save your money, you're privileged. Makes no sense at all. But we'll go with it. The student who reached out to me works in the human resources, and the class is mandatory. They teach you that if you're not part of the minority, then you cannot be discriminated against, she said. A black person cannot be racist to a white person, and a female cannot be sexist towards a man because they are men are the majority. The men are only the majority in a few instances. It is pretty close to 50-50. In some instances, there are actually more women. So now they've just lied to you. Second of all, if a black person can't be racist, then tell that to the blacks who are polar bearing, beating up white people just because they are white. Which I think is disgusting. And I think it's disgusting anytime anybody gets attacked for their race at all. But here's a sampling of the checklist. You're privileged if you're white. They don't even ask. I have never been told that I would burn in hell for my sexual orientation. Well, maybe you will burn in hell for your sexual choices. And unfortunately, that could be the case with me. In a nutshell, I don't happen to believe that as long as it's consensual, sex with more than one person is a sin. Because in the Bible, God did not have a wig out on David until David killed Bathsheba's husband by sending him to the front line and stole his wife. That, if you read the Bible, is what angered God. Not that David had many concubines, just to be clear. I still identify as the gender that I was born in. In other words, you know how to tell whether or not you stand up or sit down to piss. That makes you privileged. I work in a salary job. That makes no sense at all. I know many African Americans and people of many races work in salary jobs. When I went to college, that's ridiculous. I've had Indian teachers, Dr. Sharma. I have had black teachers. Ridiculous. I have never done my taxes myself. That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard. Absolutely irrelevant. I have an unpaid internship. I don't know what Sally Mae is. Get this on and on and on and on and on it goes. All these things make you privileged, as you can see here on the screen. The students were also asked to determine whether 32 scenarios were either harmless conversations or microaggressions. Pull up your damn diaper. You do not have a right to not be offended. As a matter of fact, you have the right to hear me tell you that if I offend you, you can go to hell. How about that? That's what I think is a good idea. If we can't express differing views, then how can we learn? She wondered. Christian students are being taught to question their values. They're being told that their values are wrong. And yet the values of the teacher, of course, can only be right, right? So guys, I can't get the actual Dunce Cap of the Month award to print. So I'm going to have to go ahead against my desire here and show you that next time, because nothing that I own ever works. Nobody should be surprised to hear that. So I will make sure that I make it the thumbnail of this video as soon as I get it done again. You have my word. But in the meantime, I can show you the Dunce Cap of the Month hat that I made up until such a time. That looks so much like Rihanna. Up until, you don't believe me, do you? Hold on a minute. Let me go ahead and go to an actual picture of Rihanna without makeup on. And you're going to see that she really does look like Junior Gorg here in this picture. I know you think I'm kidding, so I'm going to call this up. I'm not kidding a bit. All right, let me go to a different screen share option here. Here you have Junior Gorg, and there you have Rihanna. Yep. You see it? Rihanna. And Junior Gorg. Absolutely hilarious. All right, friends, here it is. I'm going to show you the Dunce Cap hat here. It says Dunce in great big letters. This is hard to do at this angle. Now, you have to notice I've got characters on here. None of you should be surprised at that either, considering my deranged sense of humor. Here you have an Indian gentleman who is saying, "Oh, well, I am not me singing woo." And here you have a Chinese gentleman, and he is saying, "Oh, me no sing umbrella." Here you have a fine Russian. You see him? I think my Russian's my favorite one. When I was going to draw him, I was worried I wasn't going to be able to draw him well. I drew him awesome. He is saying, "No talk that talk with my vodka." I guess that'd be vodka. And then last but not least, the redneck, because you all know I'm going to make fun of my own race, too. Nah, as a Walt Sang work. I am mailing this to the University of Oklahoma along with the certificate that tells them exactly why they won the award. Because they're idiots. And again, I'll get that up as a thumbnail for those of you that want to see the award. It'll be the thumbnail for this video. It's the, what, the 10th? I'll have it up by the next couple days. Friends, you're listening to The Correct Views. Sam, I'd be the Gangi signing off. I do the Dunce Cap of the Month Award because I want you to call these places that I mentioned in the sources that you read on the screen. Call them. Let them know. I don't want my children asked what sex they want to be. I don't want to be told what I'm allowed to sing. I don't want my flag banned. People, I've told you who to contact. That's why I do the show. So please contact them. Thank you, friends. Please help me out with donations if you can. TheCorrectViews@hotmail.com. Every penny you give to me goes towards a better show. Maybe even a printer that works. Wouldn't that be great? Good night, friends. God bless.